It came from.
That's right. It came from Reddit. This is the part of the show where we search all over the internet to bring you topics the community is talking about. Any topic is fair game as long as it relates to the field of, you guessed it, human factors. So this one here, this one is from Glitchy911 on the user experience subreddit. They go on to write, quitting my job 6 weeks in. How bad is this? Do I even care? Hey guys, I'm exhausted. I'm a senior designer and a single mom. I've worked for everything from agencies to FANG to high growth startups. I'm at a startup right now. I've never worked this hard in my life, and I'm a workaholic who loves design. I'm pulling 12-hour day minimums, and more common is working from around 9 a.m. to 10 p.m., taking a little break and then working until 2 a.m. or so. I've tried everything. Talking to them, they literally laughed when I told them how many hours I was working. They love this culture and worked very hard to make it this way. This is all on purpose. Waiting for new leadership. We brought in a new head of product who has a laughable 4 experience as a PM, IC level, not even senior PM. He's committed to us a year's worth of work for the next quarter when we're already underwater and a half quarter behind. Just not working more than 8 hours. We missed our deadlines and got yelled at for being the world's slowest design team. And the CEO has been, quote, pissed at us every day since. The only thing I can think of to do here is leave at this point. We've been set up to fail for Q2. I directly told them that even if every designer at the company worked for 24 hours straight on the project for all of Q2, it would still only be halfway done. The answer is always, guys, come on. We got to be aggressive here. I'm at the point where I'm angry. I hate the company. I hate the work now. I hate the leadership. I have no life and barely interact with my son anymore. They pay a lot, but that's just numbers in the bank after I reached mid-100s. Okay, good flex.
Yeah, seriously.
So now I'm interviewing and actively looking. I'm terrified of getting stuck in a similar role after this. I'm trying to tell myself there's no way these more established companies work like this, but there was no sign of this culture in the interview process. Also, it's going to be really awkward to quit after 6 weeks when the CEO is my direct boss, but I literally don't know what else to do. This is the nightmare job I've always been afraid of in tech, but luckily never encountered before. Blake, what should Glitchy 911 do?
Welcome to...
This is intense.
I don't know. Yeah. Yes and no. I mean, welcome to startups, though. I mean, it just depends on what you walk into. And I don't know. This person's a senior designer, so they're 10 tiers above me. I mean, especially on the flex on the salary. But let's try and contextualize this into some meaningful stuff that you could think here. One thing I am a little bit confused by is they mention loving being a designer and already being a workaholic, but this particular, like, either because of culture, can't like get a good design team together, no leadership, like that's even working against them. So that's just a bad sign. And then when it's getting interfering with your life and you're a workaholic and you have like children, like this whole thing of not being able to, you know, interact with their son the same way and being a single mom, that can't be okay for you. I can't imagine that feels all right at the end of the day. So if you've gotten to the point of anger, like, trust me, I've been in a startup before. I've gotten to the angry place. It's time to go. And it seems like you must have a lot of talent because you've mentioned you've worked in FANG, you've worked in other high growth startups. So maybe this is just one in the bad batch and it sounded good. The biggest thing to do is like continue interviewing. Let's see here. So don't just quit the job and walk away from it. I think that's a bad move at this point, unless you just have so much saved and you don't really need to worry about, you know, living for the next year. I would just keep interviewing and find your next position, with the biggest caveat being, like, even if you get into another startup, do a lot more research and interviewing of the company. Because if you walk into another startup, it's at the same level, it's same starting place, same series funding, you could just end up in the same situation if you're not kind of being cognizant of who you're going to end up working for, what the experience is like, getting a good sense of the CEO. And stuff like that. Cause that's, I mean, it seems like you've got the talent, you have the experience. It's just not really great leadership. Can't kind of get a good design team up under you guys. So just keep interviewing, keep pushing forward. I don't know, Nick, what kind of approach would you take to something like this?
This is awful. I hate this. I hate this. I feel so bad for this person. I mean, especially as a single mom, like I can't get that. I'm a parent, you know, with a partner who's able to look after the boy when I'm busy, and, you know, vice versa. And so I think Blake's absolutely right here. Do what's right for you. And I think you're already at the conclusion that you understand that this is not right for you.
Yeah.
This is crazy. I can't imagine working 12-hour day minimums, and even more common than 9 a.m. to 10 p.m. That's insane. That's insane. So crazy. You know, I think there's a couple things going on here right now, right? This is 6 weeks in. I would almost look for a company that allows you to work remotely, if that's possible, if that's something that you enjoy. For a couple of reasons. One, you can get away with a lot less salary than you're working with now, and you can live wherever you like. If it is just numbers in the bank to you, like Blake said, if you have the money saved up, quit now, get out. Don't give yourself that stress. That's a lot. That's a lot to deal with. And I can't imagine working in this environment for long without burning out entirely. Like, you know, if you're in this environment where you're actually just not loving it anymore, then why are you even there? Why are you doing that thing? Just find something else that you might enjoy better, or gives you a better work-life balance between the work that you're doing and the work that you're expected to do, and you know, the commitment to your family that you need. You know, that's, I think Blake kind of hit the nail on the head here. If you're talking to a company, you're interviewing them just as much as they're interviewing you. And so, you know, it's kind of hard to get a sense of culture of a company from the outside looking in, but those are types of questions that you could ask during that interview process. And certainly, you know, I would describe this experience in every interview that you have and say, this is not what I want. What's your, you know, kind of work-life balance like here? And if you get any weird vibes, maybe don't pursue it. That's kind of where I'm at.
Yeah, I mean, so one thing that I'm just noticing, and I caught, like, just in case somebody's listening to this, or when we cut this up and put it on YouTube or wherever else we put it, like, if you find yourself being angry and you hate the company, ask yourself, okay, I hate the company. Do I love the product, and do I believe in the product? Because you can change company culture. If you hate leadership, in this startup world, that turns over and often changes a lot. That's just the nature of, you know, early stage startups or high growth startups. But if you ever find yourself hating the work, that's where I think there's a really big problem, because you can't fix that for anybody but yourself. And if you're just at the point where you don't want to do human factors, you don't want to do user experience design, you don't want to be a software developer, you've really got to take a step back and either take a pause in your career life, or definitely be diving really deep into finding something else to do, or something else that will bring that meaning back into the stuff that you used to like doing and you enjoyed before. So that's a really big takeaway here. Nick is totally right. This seems like a pretty terrible situation. I think it's more common than not in some early stage startups, but regardless, you seem talented. Go find something else better to do with your time.
Get out while you can.